And for the final, the chair would be Jan Monteverde Hakonsen. Norway. He's a special advisor, an international contact point for Africa at the Research Council of Norway. He has previously worked in the International Department of Red Cross of Norway. And before that, he worked for more than 10 years based in Africa for FAO, UNICEF, and the Swedish Agency for Research Cooperation. He has been also a member of the National Commission for UNESCO in Norway since 2009. And during 4 years, he was a vice president of the Intergovernmental Council of UNESCO MOS program, the program for the management of social transformation, representing Region 1, which is Western Europe and North America. In this panel, we have as a keynote speaker, Mr. Bernard Werling, for the National Year of Global Understanding, and two case studies will be presented. The first one by Tomasz Komorowski from the Polish National Commission for UNESCO on sustainability designs in Eastern Europe. And then we will have, through video link, Professor Mohamed Saber from the National Research Center in Egypt on the issue of research and development in environmental impact assessment for sustainable development. So, Jan, you have to go.
Hello.
Thank you very much, and welcome to, especially welcome to Professor Saber. We see you on the screen, and I hope we will be luckier with you than yesterday when we had another person on video link who disappeared after a while. So please try to stay on.
Yes, I will. Yes.
Before I make some introductory remark, I would like to remind all presenters about the time limitations. Up to 25 minutes for the keynote speaker and no more than 20 minutes for the case studies. So please try to adhere to that, otherwise people will be very angry at me because lunch is coming after this. The guidelines also said that there should be no more than 20 to 25 slides for the keynote speaker and 10 to 15 for the case studies. And Professor Saber, I'm afraid I will have to ask you already on the onset to skip a few of your slides because I noticed you had quite a number of slides. Because I don't want to be rude and cut you off
I will do.
Presentation.
There's so many, right?
Anyway. This panel has the title Revolution and Innovations in Sustainable Science and Governance. I find it's quite an awesome title. We heard a bit about the French Revolution in Professor Jean Jean's presentation yesterday, but I guess this revolution refers to another time. I decided, partly because the title was so challenging, to introduce this session on a more personal note. Because in retrospect, I realized that I unwittingly have been part of, or at least a close spectator, to some of the milestones in the evolution of sustainable sciences. As you can see from my name, there's an Italian element in the middle. And that's because I have an Italian mother and I was born in Italy and I spent my first 11 years in Italy. So I only moved back to Norway when I was 11 years old. We moved to a new housing area in Oslo. And as the case often is with such new housing areas, just about all residents who moved in were families with more or less